Today, we're looking at the topic of pollution and its effects on our planet. Get ready to explore this important science lesson with me. Pollution comes in different forms. First, there's air pollution. It's invisible yucky stuff in the air that comes from things like cars, aeroplanes, and factories. Did you know that breathing dirty air can make us feel sick? Next, there's water pollution. Rubbish and chemicals sneak into rivers and oceans, making life hard for fish, corals, and other cool creatures. Did you know that some rubbish in the ocean creates huge floating garbage islands? This island isn't made of sand or trees, like a regular island. Instead, it's made of lots and lots of rubbish that gets carried by the wind and currents and ends up gathering together in one place in the ocean. The rubbish can be things like plastic bottles, bags, and other stuff that people throw away. It's yucky and not good for the sea creatures that live in the ocean. They get tangled in it, or might even eat bits of rubbish, which isn't good for them at all. Lastly, there's land pollution. When we don't throw our rubbish away properly, it turns our beautiful places into messy spots. Plastic, cans, and other litter spoil our playgrounds. Did you know that some things we throw away take forever to disappear, which means they do a lot of damage to our Earth? There are two kinds of rubbish. One is called biodegradable, and the other is non-biodegradable. Biodegradable things are like magic. When you throw them away, they break down and disappear over time. They turn into tiny pieces of matter that nature can use again. Things like banana peels and paper bags are biodegradable. But non-biodegradable stuff doesn't break down easily. It stays around for a super long time, even hundreds of years. Things like plastic bags and bottles are non-biodegradable. They can sit in the environment for ages without going away. Now let's look at ways we can help reduce pollution. Recycling is a clever way to turn old stuff into new treasures. Planting trees is great. It's like giving the earth a big leafy hug. Did you know that trees help to clean the air we breathe? They do this by taking in something called carbon dioxide through their leaves. They use sunlight, water, and a special thing called chlorophyll to turn this carbon dioxide into oxygen and a kind of sugar called glucose. The trees release the oxygen they make back into the air, and that's what we breathe. This helps make the air cleaner because it takes away some of the carbon dioxide, which is a bad thing, in large amounts. Too much carbon dioxide can cause air pollution and change the climate. We can team up and make a real difference. Use less plastic, walk, or ride a bike instead of driving, and join cleanup crews at school and in your neighborhood to make our world sparkle again. See you next time. Goodbye.